guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing well. This is a New Year's Eve makeup tutorial. Pretty sparkly eyes, long lashes, and nude lips. My favorite. I'm just gonna start by applying a primer. I don't normally, but for New Year's Eve, you might be, you know, partying or having a long night, so it's always best to ensure that your foundation is locked in place. Then I'm using this foundation. All of the products will be listed in the description box. All over my face, this is a personal favorite. It's best to stick to the foundations that you know are going to last and work well on your skin for special events, in my opinion. So this one is a nice kind of full coverage with a very, very light consistency. So next I'm going to apply some concealer. This is a few shades lighter than my foundation, as you can see. And I just like to apply that underneath my eyes in the inner corners and then blend that out with a fluffy brush. I like to set that in place with a very, very light, very kind of sheer powder, just because I find that if I set it with a normal face powder, it tends to go kind of orange. So I want to preserve that lightness. Then I'm going to go in with the Face of Australia Loose Translucent Powder, an old favorite, and this ginormous brush. This thing is like half a size of my face. Then I'm going to just pat that in. I like to set my foundation, especially if I'm going to have a long night, but of course that is personal, and I just got powder all over my nice new dress. Next I'm going to use this sleek palette, and it's basically just a highlighting palette, and I'm going to use a shade in the bottom right corner. This is just a really, really shimmery, intense highlighter, and I like to go overboard when it comes to special events like New Year's Eve because it's such a special occasion. I just said special occasion a million times, but it's true. I'm just going to place that down the bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow, and on the highest points of my cheeks. And then I'm going to apply some blush. This is a really natural shade. I wanted to kind of keep it more natural just because the eyes are going to be really intense and sparkly, so I didn't want to have like bright pink cheeks. I normally don't anyway, but especially for this look, I kind of want the focus to be on the eyes and not so much the cheeks. Next, I'm going to go in with my brow products. I just like to fill these in as much as I can with the powder, and then I go in with a crayon. The crayon just kind of gives me a little bit more definition because of the consistency. A powder will only stick so much to my skin until I have to bring in like a more heavy duty product that can kind of just create or define the arch a bit better and then elongate the tail. This is a new favorite of mine. It's by IT Cosmetics, their Brow Power Crayon, I think. I just like it a bit more than the Anastasia ones because it's a bit softer, so you don't have to pull on the skin as much. And I don't know, it's just been easier for me to use from day one. So yes, in love with this one. And I actually use warm brown instead of taupe, which is very interesting because I usually use taupe. Anyway, all right, this is the setting gel, which I just happened to get all over my eyelid. You know it's gonna be a good day when that happens. Next I'm using this ColourPop eyeshadow all over my eyelid. This is a gorgeous, very neutral, natural, like pinky, champagne-y, beige-y shade with a bit of glitter in it. And this is gonna act as a base for everything else. So I'm going to use on top of this the Stila Magnificent Metal Eyes kind of like gel glitter stuff. You would know this by now, surely. It's like the best thing in the world. I am going to pack that on my eyelid very, very heavily, so it's almost like a foil rather than when you pat it on very lightly, it comes out as more of a glitter. So I'm just going in like crazy just to get a really like strong, shiny look. And then I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay little eyeshadow. It almost comes out as a glitter if you use it very lightly, so I just very, very lightly dabbed that on top of the Stila stuff just to add some more shine. I mean, look how shiny it is already. You can't go wrong with more. Then I'm going to grab another kind of crease color from Sleek, and it's almost like a darkish kind of, well, you can see the color there anyway. I'm so bad at explaining colors. So I'm just going to use a smaller brush, and I'm going to define my crease. As you can tell, we are going to be creating a cut crease, and I like to start with a very light shade, well, kind of like a medium shade actually, just to get the kind of carve out the shape. And then I go in with a pencil brush and I blend that out with this fairly or slightly lighter shade, just to kind of make the gradient very soft and subtle. And then I go in with a bigger fluffy brush to go and blend that out even more. As you guys know, with everything to do with eyeshadow, it's all about blending, so the more blending you do, the better it'll look pretty much all the time. So I'm just working up the intensity. This is very personal, but I feel like the darker you make the crease, the more effective the cut crease is, and the more dramatic it is. So as you can see, I'm just getting darker with that sleek shade in the very, very crease, and then slowly blending that out with a fluffier brush. You can go in with a black if you like to make it really dark, but I just chose not to. So now I'm going to use this gel liner to create a very thin line across my lash line. I wanted to make it as thin as possible so that all the shininess and brilliance of my eyelids is going to show through. So I'm just doing that very carefully and then creating a very fine wing. I feel like this definitely does need like eyeliner and definitely winged eyeliner for this look. It just kind of balances it out. Otherwise, it looks like it's missing something. So I always try to film me, you know, doing my wing on camera, but I end up having to get so close to the mirror that I like get out of frame. Sorry guys. I'm just going to use that Urban Decay shade again underneath my lower lashes. Just pretty roughly. It doesn't have to be perfect. And then going in with the original sleek shade and darkening that up. I just wanted some subtle like definition on the lower lash line to help balance out the upper lashes. And then I'm going to go in with a smaller brush and a stiller shade and add some of that in the inner corner and bring it just slightly underneath the lower lash line in the corner just to open up the eyes a little bit. Then I'm going to go in with some mascara, just heavily creating the upper lashes as much as you possibly can. And then I'm going to go in with a waterline pencil in my waterline. Funnily enough, this is black, but it ends up coming like out as more of a dark brown, so I kind of liked that anyway, so it kind of worked out for me, but just a little side note, a little warning, heads up. and then I'm going to apply some mascara on my lower lashes. Then I am going to go in with some crazy long but beautiful lashes. I can't pronounce the brand, so I'm not going to try. Straight onto my lashes, you know how it goes. These are very, very subtle, but that's kind of what I wanted. I just wanted some extra like oomph. And these are very, very long lashes, so if you have kind of short to medium lashes, probably not gonna work. Now I'm just using my favorite lip liner. This is just my go-to, so I always go to it, but it doesn't make sense, for special occasions, because I know it's gonna look the best. So then I'm just going to, line my lips, overdraw them a little bit, as we all do these days. Then I'm going in with a ColourPop shade, which is just very, very matte, but it's kind of looked a little bit too like nudey, peachy, orangey, if that makes sense. So I went in with the Stila Stay All Day Liquid Lipstick, which is a bit more of a pink, which kind of just balanced it out a little bit, made it a little bit more nude pink, or nude zone pink, which is my favorite shade. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, see how it all turned out. Let me know what you think, and have an amazing New Year's. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.